What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Today, I'm going to be sharing something that I've been waiting so long to share, and it's actually how to make the most of your 20s. I just made it to my 30th birthday just about a month ago, and I've got some things that I think have made a massive difference in my life over the last 10 years, and I want to share them with you guys. Let's go. So while I'm really excited to actually hit the 3-0, I honestly feel the 20s were a pivotal time for me, both in personal development and professional growth. So the five things that I'm gonna be sharing with you today are things that I have experience in, and I really do feel these have made me a stronger person, and I think they'll be really useful for anybody watching that are in their 20s right now. The very first one I'm gonna be talking about today is gonna be to learn to value experiences. Now, one thing I'm not gonna do is knock material things. I definitely wanted to get a nice car with my sales job. I wanted to get watches, and I still do appreciate toys. But what I am gonna say is that over the last 10 years, the trips that I've taken, the things that I've learned as hobbies have all done a lot for me as a person and have given me great memories. So while I still love a good toy or a materialistic thing, at the end of the day, I've really learned to value experiences for a couple of different reasons. Now, one of the first reasons I'm going to say that learning to value experiences over material things is so important is going to be based on my first car, my first luxury car that I bought. And while the car was great and I loved it and I spent probably too much money on it, what I really remember about the car, outside of the infotainment system that actually worked, is the stories, the memories that I had with the people in the car, with the places that I went, and the laughs and the memories I made in the car. The difference there is that when I'm talking about 20, 30, 40 years down the road, or just 10 years down the road, what I really remember and really appreciate and what really brings my emotion to the surface when I think about that thing is the actual experience and the stories and the laughs I had in that car. What material item do you have that you actually get to share with other people? Maybe you don't have it anymore. What really brings the emotion to the surface? The emotions of joy or sadness or anything like that? Is it the actual materialistic toy or item, or is it the actual experience you had with other people around that item? The other reason I really feel that you need to value experience over a materialistic thing is if you're sitting down at a bar or you are trying to network and you're walking around the room and there's five different people. If you go up and talk to all these five different people, what do you think is gonna be the easiest thing to talk about, connect with, to relate to? Is it gonna be a different travel story that you might actually know about? You've been to a couple different countries and all those five people have been to different countries. Maybe one of those people have gone out and actually raced a car, so an experience there. Or maybe they've gone snowboarding versus owning a luxury watch. What do you think is gonna be the easiest way to actually connect and relate to people? It's gonna be those experiences. I might have a higher value to that because I've been in sales and I really do like learning from other people and hearing other people's fascinating stories, but that is a real life example that experiences give you that, memories give you that, stories give you that opportunity to connect with other people and relate versus, let's say, a luxury watch or a vehicle. Number two is to learn to value personal development. I think a lot of people do this on varying scales, and I really do have a great appreciation for the personal development I've had over the last 10 years. The big reason behind this is that every single one of us have some kind of value, whether that's what we've learned, whether it's our unique backstory, whether it's our unique experience, and what we're good at. Everybody is different and everybody has some kind of value. I spent almost $28,000 on getting my pilot's license because I had to work and also learn how to fly. There is a lot of personal development there. I was getting my ass kicked. I got distracted. I had other priorities, but I still got it done. And there is nothing I regret about spending that money on that versus a watch or a car or a new house or something like that because I have a skill other people do not have. And I get to have those experiences again and share those with other people. I wouldn't change a thing about what I did to get my pilot's license. So the big takeaway there, make sure that you learn to value personal development and invest in yourself. That can be a new skill, that can be a new hobby, that can be you reading books every morning. Whatever you want to think is your way of building your knowledge and your mindset and your person, do it. Number three, get uncomfortable and take strategic risks. When I graduated college, I was so motivated by making a bunch of money and getting out of debt that it actually overpowered the fact that trying to move out of state to pick up a job was gonna be uncomfortable, was gonna be risky, and was gonna scare the shit out of me. But it was so powerful that I actually took that risk. And so I moved to Savannah, Georgia for my very first job. And then I took a promotion out to Los Angeles, and I vividly remember looking out the window, landing at LAX, thinking, what am I doing? What the hell am I actually doing? Moving across country for even a more risky position. I can look back and say that getting uncomfortable, taking those strategic risks have been great for me. All of our learning, all of the growth and personal development, everything is outside of our comfort zone. So if you're not regularly pushing on that comfort zone and trying to get uncomfortable and get used to that, then how much are you actually growing? I'm not saying it's easy, and I'm not saying, again, that it's comfortable, because hence the uncomfortable nature to getting outside of your comfort zone. But I can tell you that I don't regret taking the risks. I don't regret taking that uncomfortable step in my life across the last 10 years, whether that's moving, taking new roles, learning new things, and failing, which ties directly to a very cliche thing, but I have to say it because I really think this has helped me get past that comfort zone. And it's the fact that any experience that you have is going to be a win or a learning experience. That learning experience piece is a failure. It sucks. But what has allowed me to step outside my comfort zone is the fact that if it's a win, great, you got what you want. If it's a learning experience, it pushes you to say, how did I fail? How did I get to this point? How or what did I learn here? And it goes back to number two, you're now growing as a person. Most experiences are going to be a win or a learning experience. Tweak the way you think about that failure, that loss. And then it becomes a lot easier to take that strategic risk or take that uncomfortable step into something you're not used to yet. Number four is get transparent. Now, I'm still working on this piece and I can always get better at it, but I've come a long way in the last 10 years. And I really do feel that being transparent and being honest really make you stand out as somebody different, because not a lot of people are that way. Looking back now, I can say that two things really changed over those 10 years. I really started to look at my why when I was about 25, 26, and really understand once I made the money that I really wanted to do, I really had to step back and take a look and say, well, why am I doing this? And it made me really explore my why. And when I really started to define what my why was and what I was waking up for every single morning, I really started to tie a value to my time. And so at that point, when something doesn't align with your why or what you're trying to get accomplished, and you have a value to every single second and minute you have, then it becomes a lot easier to be transparent about saying no versus yes, or telling somebody how you feel or your thoughts on something, because you've got this target and this focus, and then you've also got this value to your time. So if something doesn't align with that, it becomes a lot easier to become transparent. The other side to that why and the value of time is you really do begin to care for others' opinions a lot less, because you've got a why, you've got a definition. You still care for people and you still listen to other people's opinions, but you really start to take a look at when somebody critiques something or somebody has thoughts on you or somebody you've never even met tries to judge you, you become really strong and don't really care too much about what they think, because they don't know you. They don't know what you've been through. They don't know your story, where you've had your successes or where you've had your failures. And the only person that knows that is you. So why should you care too much about somebody that doesn't know you? Number five would be super happy with you. I left a job after 5 years in sales. I started traveling almost 6 days a week. I was unhappy. And while I didn't really want to leave my city of Seattle and my friends and my family over there, I had to pull the ripcord. I didn't know where I was going to go, but I just had to do it. I don't recommend that to everybody, because it could have been really bad, but fortunately I had some passive income that I had built up on my own. But the thing is that I was unhappy and I moved back to Florida. And when I came back to Florida, all I was thinking about is how much I hated the state and what I was doing and all these excuses. And I was unhappy with where I was and the lack of my why. Like, what was I trying to do? I hit my money goals that I had so passionately pursued when I first graduated, and I really didn't have a strong why to fall back on when I finally hit that goal. And so when I got back to Florida, I really kind of blamed it on the state and just being back. And it really made me think and explore the fact that the only person that has control over your happiness is you. Actions, reactions, mindset. Those are the three things that you control. And I had to find that out. While I still don't love Florida, it doesn't matter what city I'm in. It doesn't matter what job I have. If I know why I'm waking up in the morning and what I'm trying to get done in a couple of years, then I am happy. I am content with where I'm at. And that is one of the most important things I think I picked up in those 20s. You have got to be so unbelievably happy with you. And I'm not saying that's gonna happen as soon as you graduate. I really thought I knew what I wanted when I graduated college. I wanted to make a shit ton of money, and that was it. I hit 25, 26, and I almost had a midlife crisis. It was because I didn't have my definition. I'm still learning what that is. I'm still picking up new things. I'm still trying to understand exactly how I'm gonna impact others and what my why is, but I have a much better definition, an internalized why that is much stronger than just make a bunch of money. So those are the big things I got for you guys today. I really hope that is gonna make some kind of a difference, and I hope that you are really gonna explore and have a blast in your 20s. I feel better than ever at 30. I really do feel age is just a number. There's a reason that they're 85-year-olds still flying planes and still working harder than some people that are at 32. And it's all about your mindset. So what my next video is actually gonna be is talking about why I chose sales. And it's because I've talked about sales a couple times. I haven't shared too much about why I actually picked this profession, even though I did kind of fall into it, but why I've continued to stay headstrong forward on it. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, go ahead and press the like button. If you want to come back for more content like this as I continue to grow this channel and share my experiences, go ahead and press subscribe and the bell next door. I hope you have a great rest of your weekend. See ya.